I bought a Nextbit Robin from 2016. Why? Because I make bad decisions. Some of you may remember this phone and some of you may not, as it kind of just disappeared just as fast as it released. But yeah, it's almost 6 years old. Why would I buy a 6-year-old Android? Well, for a few reasons, actually. I've been thinking a lot lately about longevity and lifespan regarding a technology, and more specifically, smartphones. I've never owned a smartphone for more than a couple years, so I was really curious how such an old phone would operate. And this one hasn't been updated in years. The last update it received was Android Nougat, or 7.1, and the last security update is from 2017. But we'll try and fix that later. And secondly, I wanted to try this phone out because I remember really wanting one when it released, and I never got to try one. I mean, just look at this design. I also chose this phone because the backstory is pretty interesting. The company that released it, Nextbit, actually funded the release of the Robin on Kickstarter, and the phone officially released in February of 2016. The price started at $299 for early backers, then $399 finally at retail release. $399 is a pretty good price, but phones were cheaper back in 2016, and this was still a really good deal for what you were getting. It was competing against phones like the Nexus 6P and the iPhone 6S. It had a super attractive build and was offered in two very cool colorways, with a third offered in a small batch for early backers. I really, really liked the mint color, but I couldn't find any for a good price.
Oh man! Oh god! Oh man! Oh god!
It looks blue a lot of the time, but it's decent for hiding fingerprints, and I love the different colored power button. It's similar to the Pixel in that regard. That power button also hides the fingerprint sensor. The build was Gorilla Glass 4 on the front and plastic everywhere else. And of course it was destroyed by Jerry Rig everything. But I really liked the thin build and rounded edges. The screen is 5.2 inches at 1080p, and it featured a Snapdragon 808, which was top of the line at the time. It had dual stereo speakers on the front and 3GB of RAM. These may sound low spec now, but they were actually really good value for the money at the time, like OnePlus used to offer in their early days. The Robin's biggest feature at release was the promise of cloud storage. While the phone only shipped with 32GB of onboard storage, the company promised an additional 100GB of cloud storage that could be accessed to free up storage when needed. It seemed kind of revolutionary at the time, but given what happened with the company, it actually turned out to be a weak point of the phone. So now let's move on to the reason I bought this. How does a 5-year-old Android hold up today? It's not great, but let's dive in a little deeper. As I said, the processor is a Snapdragon 808. While it was top of the line in 2016, it kind of shows its age and day-to-day use today. This is probably a limitation of the RAM as much as the SoC, but apps can be a little laggy when opening from memory. Overall though, it's still very usable and I was happy to see that. The dual speakers get really loud but have a very bad distortion and pop at max volume, but watching content on the phone is actually not terrible. It's super pocketable and has really easy handheld use due to the size, and it just makes me wish we had more powerful, smaller phones today. I'm not really going to grade the battery life as it's only at about 80% of the original 2600 mAh battery, which is really small anyways, but most reviews at the time did note that the battery wasn't one of its strong suits. So what about the new revolutionary cloud storage, the future of smartphones? Well, as you might have guessed, given that there's not a Robin 2 or 3 floating around out there today, it's been shut down. Less than a year after release, Nextbit surprised everyone and sold the company to Razer. You know, the RGB guys, who would go on to release the first Razer phone based on the Robin's design language. You can kind of see the similarities when you put them side by side. To be fair, Razer kept the cloud storage going for another year, but eventually shut it down, leaving everyone who purchased the phone with only their onboard 32GB. I would have loved to try the cloud storage function, but it was sort of gimmicky from the start. It was only set up to offload apps and photographs to the cloud when you were low on storage and nothing else. No messages or songs or whatever you would have put on your phone back in 2016. So I'm not sure how useful it would have been in the first place. It probably would have been cheaper for Nextbit just to throw 64GB of storage on there and not have to worry about the cloud storage, but it was a pretty cool marketing tool. I'm curious how long Nextbit would have supported the cloud storage anyway, since running servers costs money and they were already planning more phones for the future when they sold to Razer. Regardless, microSD card support would have gone a long way in keeping this phone more viable for future use. The OS of the phone is a unique take on Android and released on Android Lollipop, or 5.1. It was updated to Nougat 7.1 before updates were finally stopped. That's not super good, as that's only a couple generations, but I guess it's better than nothing. I like the overall operating system design, but they went for a little different route by not offering an app drawer similar to the iPhone. They have a couple cool little features built in, like the ability to swipe from the left of any menu to reach an expanded menu, and a persistent bar across the screen to access the cloud features. But getting back to my earlier discussion on extending the lifespan of devices, Android has always had a bit of an advantage over Apple in the ability to use custom ROMs made by the community. This used to be really big, but it's kind of died down in recent years. I was pretty sure there wasn't going to be anyone still making updates for the Robin, as it's almost 6 years old at this point, but I was surprised to find that there was a custom ROM from one of my favorite, Lineage OS. If you're not familiar with that one, they offer a clean ROM without any added bloatware, kind of like the Pixel devices. One cool thing I found was that the Robin actually shipped with an unlocked bootloader and publicly stated that the warranty wouldn't be voided if you bricked your device loading a custom ROM. So I loaded up Lineage OS on there and suddenly my super old device was running Android 11. Unfortunately, that's kind of where the fun stopped. The older chipset and limited RAM seem to struggle with the ROM, and it's pretty laggy when opening apps or trying to play games. Now, this could be because I'm using a nightly build and not the latest stable release, but it's probably just limitations of the device trying to run newer software. But the biggest advantage of these custom ROMs is probably updated security patches. Suddenly, this 6-year-old device I was using went from a security patch updated in 2017 to November of 2021. That's really cool. It's really awesome that these modders take the time to keep old devices like these going after the companies that released them have long since abandoned them. So how does a nearly 6-year-old camera hold up? Well, it's only got one on the back for starters. That was completely normal at the time, as dual cameras wouldn't pop up for another few years. Yeah. The camera is 13 megapixels with an f2.2 aperture, and with good lighting you can get some pretty decent shots out of it. I was actually kind of surprised, but it's not mind-blowing. It can record 4K video, but it doesn't have optical image stabilization. But overall, you could get by using it today. So what's it like using a 5, almost 6-year-old Android phone? Well, it's not nearly as bad as I thought it would be. I'll always appreciate the design of the Nextbit Robin, and I hate that the company sold to Razer and never got to release a follow-up, which they were actually working on before they sold. But at the end of the day, it is actually possible to use a 5-year-old Android thanks to the awesome community that keeps it going. And I'm really glad I finally got my hands on a Nextbit Robin. I might buy a new battery and try to swap that out sometime. Anyways, that's all I got. Thanks for watching, everyone. Until next time.